Our first item of business this afternoon is time for reflection, and our time for reflection leader today is Dr. Jonathan Reyes, Executive Director of the Department of Justice, Peace and Human Development for the United States Conference of Catholic Bishops in Washington.
Well, I'm here because I was invited by His Grace Leo Cushley of Edinburgh, and he just asked me to come and speak about Oscar Romero, part of my past, part of my work in the United States, in both with poverty and social justice issues and with the U.S. Catholic bishops. And I have a Mexican father, and my mother's descended from Scottish background, so it was a perfect fit, and I was delighted to come.
I'm in Scotland this week to give a series of lectures on one shining example of this kind of integral human concern, Oscar Romero, Archbishop of San Salvador from 1977 to 1980.
It's quite moving, actually, that you can stand in front of a secular governing body and actually talk about someone like Oscar Romero. So it was quite moving. It was fun to see. It's a gorgeous building. A real honor, really.
I'm Mike Rumbles. I'm the Northeast Regional MSP. I'm based up in Aberdeenshire, and I'm delighted to be here at this evening's reception and talk from Dr. Reyes about Archbishop Oscar Romero. And I think there are some important lessons for us, all those of us who are interested in social change and social justice, and quite frankly, changing the world for better. So I'm here tonight to introduce Dr. Reyes and also to listen very carefully to what he's got to say to us, and I look forward to the address.
Well, there are a lot of different messages of his life, but a couple that stick to my mind and are relevant to now. One is just that everything Oscar Romero said, everything he stood for, care for the most vulnerable, justice, he lived. And I think that this is a day and age in which all of us need to hear, not just Parliament, not just politicians, not just church leaders, but every one of us needs to hear the very simple message, live what you preach.
Well, I was really pleased to do this because I vividly remember Oscar Romero's death and the shock that that created around the world. And all he was doing was founding his arguments on the gospel, really. And for that he was shot. And for me, it shows how revolutionary that is. But I very much hope that his name is going to live on, because I think he was the most shining example of a shepherd in our church.
I think he's the kind of figure who can actually serve to maybe, just maybe, bring some of our conversations together. Romero doesn't, despite what some people have said about him, Romero doesn't land easily on what people might call the left or the right. Romero's a churchman of high principle who died for what he believed. And I think it's figures like this that can help us maybe overcome some of the fracturing of our political situation, some of that breakdown in conversation and dialogue. So it's my hope that he's a peacemaker in his legacy as well as he tried to be in his life.
Well, I'm delighted to co-sponsor this event. And it's interesting that it's a cross-party event, which I think is testament both to the fact that Oscar Romero was an incredible figure and the fact that he believed in fighting for social justice across all boundaries, across political boundaries and others. And, you know, it's so important that in the centenary of his birth, we pay testament to his achievement. And it's great that we've got the Catholic Church here in Parliament, and it's great that we've got a speaker of Dr. Reyes' caliber to come and talk to us about the life and work of such an important figure.
His life until the last 3 years was a good life. He was a good bishop, he was a good priest, but it was largely hidden. It was the last 3 years of his life that made him an international figure. And I think sometimes we think of saints as just those who have this amazing life throughout and they're always being praised. That's not Romero. Romero's a man who was faithful, lived a heroic life, but ended his life in heroism. And we want to emulate that as well. What he did for those first 60 years, very few people knew. It was the last three that really mattered. And that's true for all of us.